Okay, so it is now after Halloween, and I did not get a chance to show you guys what we did with this until now. This is what it ended up looking like, the stalks. And I will get a close-up on all this so you can see exactly what happened here and what we did. For these were just, the skulls were just door knockers, and we actually took the door knocker off of them. They were just little cheapy ones from Dollar Tree. And put screws, it's kind of hard to see it, in there where the door knocker actually attached to hold them on. Originally we had stapled them on by the holder. Well, fortunately this fell over by the wind and it broke them off. So this actually was a much better idea. Plus I'm going to be storing this outside, so much sturdier. The distressing, and I'll show you, one, we wrote witch across it. It was just something a little extra to add to it. The distressing, we took sandpaper to it. We painted the whole thing black, obviously, and it's kind of hard to tell, but we actually have white on here. And what we did was, my mom actually did this. She took a sock, an old sock, or you can even take an old rag, dipped it in the paint, and then rubbed all over to kind of give it a really weathered effect. You can kind of see it a little bit there. And then when she got done with that, and after that dried, she took sandpaper, and then just kind of randomly, no real rhyme or reason to it, you know, sanded it down to the bare wood. Then we covered it with, of course, we got the birds on there, and we covered the birds with the moss. We had to make this thing extremely safe because we were going to have kids coming in this. So the little things are actually, the birds are actually stapled in, and you can't really see it. But then to cover the staples and to cover the wire on the bird's feet, we covered it with the moss. From there, I actually had these old handles from, they originally were on my gate. We put these on here, and I didn't get to finish this, and next year I hopefully will. Next year there will actually be a, ooh, there's a spider. Next year, I hate spiders. Next year there will actually be a big groove going all the way across it to make it look like it can actually open and close, because this one obviously cannot. But we wanted to make it look like that, so we just found this cheap plastic chain with a lock. Spirit, I think, is where we found it. Put it on there, and it actually worked out great. We also got, for the kids to put their hands in, some shackles, hand shackles. And then this is actually a walking dead prop with added chain that we would put around their neck. Now, I made the holes bigger than I actually really needed to. So to counteract that, because the hole where the head is just way too big, we took some old black fabric, cut it just enough so that people could get their heads in there, but still have it tight enough around their neck that, like, and head, that it would still look like it was part of the backdrop. And I'll actually go around back here and show you what we did with that. We just stapled it on, and then to cover the staples, we took black duct tape and went all the way around it. So, very simple thing. We got some fake ivy, put it going down one side. And I should say that the distressing is all the way down and around, all the way through this entire project here. Put some creepy cloth on it. I believe we had a rat. There'll be some rats. We had a snake and the ivy. We just really went wild. I mean, it's really up to you, however you want this to look. So yeah, there you go. I mean, that's the end result. It was a huge success, and I mean absolutely huge. I could not have made, I think, a better prop at all, really. I still have pictures coming in from that night of people that had their kids in this thing that got themselves in it. It was a very big success. And it'll come in handy even more next year when we actually do the theme with the witch. So there's that. That's the end of my tutorial. I hope it wasn't too confusing. First tutorial I've ever made, so there you go. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope you guys, you know, at least got some helpful advice out of this.